Captain Avery's all right.
Harbor's safe as it's going to get. You ever get a gnawing in your belly to do something crazy? Reason and sense keep steering you clear.
What's on your mind?
You're the only mainlander I'd ever tell of this. So hear me out. The Red Death. May have heard of it. The big monster lives beneath the waves. Only strikes when the fog is thick. People think it's some drunken sailor's tale. But no one goes sailing when there's a fog on. In their bones, they know there's something out there.
This whole Red Death sounds like bullshit to me.
Then there's no danger in looking for it, then. With my business here done, and knowing someone like yourself, I seek to end this unholy terror. Dozens of boats over the long years been claimed by it. I mean to hunt this Red Death. Are you with me?
How do we go about this hunt?
No one's encountered the Red Death up close and lived. But many folk have seen its glow from afar. I've been collecting the details of those sightings for years. We take our boats, and I can get us there. I know it, but it could be the deadliest challenge we ever face. So I'll understand if you pass.
Count me in.
Bring whatever weapons of death and mass destruction you got. Meet by the docks. You take your boat, I'll take mine. This trip is going to test our mettle more than anything.
Thank you.
Nice.
Thank you. sweet.
Thank you.
Knowing can help. Basement.
Yes, I'm the detective.
Thank goodness. Let me just open the door for you. Well, it's about time the police sent someone out to investigate. Well, it's about time the police sent someone out to investigate. We have many important residents, and they are very worried.
What happened? Who died?
It's Mr. Parker, the primary owner and financier for the hotel. This is just a disaster. They're at the crime scene again. Don't they realize that they're going to disturb the evidence? You'd better come with me, Detective. Shouting. But the detective has arrived and shall begin the investigation henceforth. Please return to your rooms until the detective has examined the crime scene and had a chance to come speak with you. Have a look at the crime scene for clues. You are free to question the residents, but their safety is our priority. So unless you have solid evidence, I would avoid accusations. Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
Your residents are robots.
Not robots, Detective. Well, not exactly, anyway. I believe the term they use is robo-brain. Back before the war, the residents decided the best way to wait it out was to put their brains inside robotic chassis. Was there anything else?
Tell me about the victim.
Mr. Ezra Parker was the primary owner and financier for the hotel. He had vast experience managing venture projects around the world. It was his idea to have our premier clients become investors in the vault section of the hotel. He worked with Vault Tech to have this built to their every specification. Was there anything else?
I'm not sure where I should start.
I suppose you should try to figure out how he died, and then who had the means and motive to kill him. Once you have enough evidence, then I suppose you'll need to confront the killer. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here should you need me.
Looks like the brain enclosure was smashed. Is this blood?
Red paint? This isn't blood. It's red paint.
Protect and serve.
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
That's not blood around the body. It's red paint.
Mr. Santiago would definitely have red paint. But surely he wouldn't have... Would he? This is just terrible, Detective. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here should you need me.
Protect and serve.
Why'd you do it, Hahbahh? He deserved better than that.
You think I'm stupid? I saw the way he looked at you. You gonna tell me that's nothing?
It wasn't like that. We were friends. He helped me out of a tight spot or two is all.
I couldn't stand by like some pasty-faced Percy while he put the moves on my best girl.
But now the law is on our tail. What are we going to do?
Come away with me. Let's leave this dark hole of a city behind. We can be in Buenos Aires by tomorrow.
Oh, I want to believe you, I do, but... Never let us go.
Then we'll make our stand here. I've got a gun for each of us.
No, 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 no! The line is... Then we'll make our stand here. Two lovers together with a bullet for each of them.
God. Why can't I ever get that line? Forget it. I can't do this right now.
Fine. I'm going to the beach. Well, now, it isn't the brave detective. I haven't seen someone with a body like that in far, far too long.
Thanks. I suppose. I had some questions about the case.
Surely you'd prefer to hear some tales from my storied acting career rather than talk about some dreadful murder.
All right.
He'll deny ever saying it, but Keith once told me he caught Vince Natale and Sergio Amore together at a nightclub in a compromising situation. Did you need something else?
What were you and Keith talking about when I came in?
Oh, that? We were rehearsing! Gotta stay sharp if we're going to rebuild Hollywood. But Keith always gets flustered when he's upset. Did you need something else?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Well, it is a bit strange how obsessed Santiago has been with the murder. I mean, he's always been a bit obsessive, though. He did a whole series of paintings of me. Hundreds! Said I was his muse. It was flattering for a while. But the man is a bit much. Even for me. Did you need something else?
Tell me about yourself.
My favorite subject. Simply put, darling, I'm the greatest actress in the world. When this international scuffle blows over, I shall return to the silver screen and lead the world to a new golden age of cinema. Did you need something else?
Maybe later.
I'll be around, languishing from your inattention.
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
What were you and Gilda talking about when I walked in?
Hmm? Oh, we were just rehearsing a scene. Nothing to worry about.
Tell me about yourself.
Well, as you probably know, I'm an actor. I don't like to brag about it, but my last picture, The Fighting Furies, did top the box office.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
It's obviously Santiago. He keeps going back to look at the crime scene.
Maybe later.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.
Yes. Thank you.
to the Vault 118 gift shop. Need to restock on hunting or fishing supplies?
Did you have any thoughts on the case?
I'm afraid not, Detective. We're really at a loss, which is why I was sent to find you. Forgot a personal item at home.
What have you got?
Keepsakes, hunting equipment, and a variety of small personal items. Looking for a gift to bring back to that special someone?
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Something for everyone.
Protect and serve.
It's okay. I've gone to a few museums.
Come with me. tell me, what does this beast say to you?
It's about composition. The balance of colors and emotions and the struggle to maintain internal order.
Indeed. This was the last piece I did in a series of portraits of Gilda. Number 1378. Her emotional landscape is superimposed on the portrait. The reality of the subject is distorted as the ego attempts to project itself. This way. Tell me, what does this one say to you?
It's the war! Bombs from every direction. No up or down. The world turned on its head.
I suppose in a way it must be. Art shapes the world, and the world shapes art in return. All art must therefore be constantly reborn through the lens of contextual and historic interpretation. We must ascend. And what about this one? And please be honest, for art without honesty is just politics.
Can we talk about the murder?
There will be plenty of time for that. We have more important matters to attend to. Truth be told, this is my best-selling piece. I did this series under a pseudonym, of course. This series has made more money than any of my serious works. And I did the whole thing as a lark. What does that tell you about the value of art to the common man, huh? Ah, my fellow connoisseur of the art. Here to see my latest work.
Tell me about yourself.
What is there to tell? I am one of the premier artists in the world. My work is primarily in oil paint, but I have been known to do sculpture or performance art as well.
I found red paint at the crime scene. Know anything about that?
No, actually. Ezra borrowed my last can. Now I can't find it.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
The person you should be looking at is Juliana Riggs. That Philistine would not know art from her own excrement. She and Ezra had a rather dramatic fight recently. You could hear her banshee screeches all the way across the hotel. I don't know. I was painting at the time, and I was trying to block it out. Though I bet Gilda probably heard that. Maybe you should check with her.
I think you should explain why you keep returning to the crime scene.
It's for inspiration, Detective. The others do not like to think about it, but even we shall die someday. Like Prometheus' torch, it kindles within me the fire to create as much art as I can with the time that I have.
It sounds like you've done a lot of paintings of Gilda. Why her?
Our Gilda is a very singular creature, Detective. Do you not see the joie de vivre from within her? I have never met another who clings to life so tenaciously, who lives so in the moment. I must admit, I was quite smitten with her for a time.
You're still in love with Gilda, aren't you?
So what if I am? What business is it of yours? She deserves someone who truly understands her ephemeral beauty, not that brute actor.
Maybe later.
Good. I hope my paintings are able to open your mind to new possibilities.
Thank you.
answer some questions.
Sure, darling. What did you need?
Apparently, Juliana had a big argument with Ezra a few days before he died. Did you happen to overhear any of the conversation?
Oh, yes. I haven't seen a woman go off like that since Teresa Dubois fired her costume designer. But to get back to your question, it was fever pitch, Detective. She had apparently gone to the Overseer's office to check on the state of things and found it in horrible disrepair. But, and this is where it gets interesting, it sounded like she found something that really set her off. Couldn't hear what, though. Did you need something else?
I've gotten the impression you've had an affair with Santiago.
Look, I love Keith, I do. But sometimes he just can't give me the attention I need. A girl gets lonely, Detective. It only lasted a few dozen years. The man's a bit much, even for me. Did you need something else?
Never mind.
I'll be around, languishing from your inattention.
Died last month. This is Scruffy. Remember?
Oh. Of course. Silly me.
Just let me have a look at the neural interface matrix and I'm sure I can clear that.
No. No, it's not that. I've just caught another cold. Probably something that got in when they sent Pearl out.
Oh, God. Not this again. Last month you were convinced you had the measles.
You're not a doctor. What would you even know about it? Besides, I think it may be malaria.
First of all, I am a doctor.
Yes, but not a real doctor. Robotics isn't an actual medical degree.
Secondly, I've told you time and again, you can't get sick inside the suit. It's not physically possible.
I know when I'm getting sick, Bert. Now why don't you just wander off and play in your lab? Mr. Scruffy and I are going to rewrite the will, so he will get everything when I die because horrible Bert didn't believe me.
Oh, God, Juliana.
Whatever.
I'm going to the lab. Look in it. Did you need something?
I heard that Juliana and Ezra had an argument a few days before he was found dead. Tell me about that.
Well, I was in my lab at the time, so I didn't hear it. But Juliana has always been rather critical of Mr. Parker. I think she found something in the Overseer's office. I wasn't listening when she told me about it. I kind of had my head in my research. I don't know, really. I try to let her handle all the money stuff. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Tell me about yourself.
Well, I'm a scientist. You've probably met my wife, Juliana, already. I'm not sure what else to say, really. Oh, was there something else, you detective?
Tell me about your research.
Well, I was one of the leads on the team that created the first robo. The precursors to our model. Most people don't find it all that interesting, and I'd rather not bore you. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
I'd like to hear more about your research.
Oh, wonderful. No one else here. Functionally, this model is more or less the same as the previous versions I worked on.
Right.
The voice modulator seems to have some minor issues interfacing with the neural matrix, which can add some moodiness. But that's easily solved with regular tune-ups. Was there something else, Detective?
I'd like to hear more about your research.
Was there something else, Detective?
I'd like to hear more about your research.
I'm afraid that's really all I should say about it. I mean, it is still classified. Oh, was there something...
Robobrains have a voice modulator? Tell me about that.
That's what allows us to recreate our original voices. They can mimic any normal human voice, actually. I've speculated for some time that the issues we had with our recruited subjects is due to the brain attempting to preserve a sense of self. Maintaining our original voices helps reinforce the neural network, sort of like playing music for an Alzheimer patient. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
Oh, well, that's not really my field of expertise, but I'm sure there are probably some clues at the crime scene. Oh, was there something else, Detective?
Maybe later.
Very well. I'll just get back to my work then.
Tell me about yourself.
I'm Juliana Riggs, heiress to the Riggs fortune and wife of Bert Riggs. I'm not sure what else you expected.
I heard you had a big fight with Ezra a few days ago. Care to explain?
Oh, well, it wasn't that big a deal, really. He wanted more money to pay for repairs on the hotel. I wasn't feeling well that day and lashed out a bit at the poor man. I really should have listened to him.
What's with all the junk in here?
These are our things. We're just waiting till the war blows over so we can bring them back to the mansion.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
If you ask me, it's one of those actors. Or that horrible painter. Their type is always the cause of violence.
Maybe later.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective.
Protect and serve.
Thank you. Progress on construction of the second wing of the vault is completely stalled. Once the premier area of the vault had been completed, funding seems to have been cut off. My supervisors have informed me that they haven't received payment from Mr. Parker, and Vault-Tec won't pay out of pocket to continue construction. I've repeatedly approached Ezra about the finances, but he keeps telling me that Mrs. Riggs hasn't transferred the funds. However, when I asked her, Juliana said that she had just given Ezra extra for the gold paint in the rooms. I've hired an investigator to look for signs of embezzlement in a few weeks.
Sounds like Ezra was embezzling from his investors.
Protect and serve.
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
The door to the Overseer's office is locked.
Oh, yes. Mr. Parker locked it a while back, after finding out that one of the other residents had been inside. Said it wasn't safe. If the key isn't on him, it's probably in Mr. Parker's room. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here should you need me.
Protect and serve.
Perfect. A baseball bat? Huh. What's this doing here?
Hello again, Detective. Was there anything else?
I found the murder weapon.
Oh, no. That's the bat from Mr. McKinney's movie. You don't think he could be involved, do you? I can't imagine him ever doing such a thing. Was there anything else?
Never mind.
I'll be here, should you need me.
There's evidence Ezra was embezzling from his investors.
Oh, well, I really don't believe that. Mr. Parker wouldn't do such a thing, I'm sure.
Never mind.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective.
My fellow connoisseur of the art. Here to see my latest work.
Never mind.
Did you have any thoughts about the murder?
If you ask me, it's one of those actors. Or that horrible painter. Their type is always the cause of violence.
Never mind.
Good luck catching the murderer, Detective.
Thank you.
Hello, Detective. How can I help? Did you have questions about the case?
I found your baseball bat at the crime scene. Care to explain how it got there?
Someone is clearly trying to frame me for the murder. It's probably Santiago. You saw him skulking around the crime scene.
Never mind.
Okay. Just let me know how I can help.